Hello and welcome to this full presentation of our research paper, A Framework for the Automatic Generation of FPGA-based New Data Processing Accelerators in Smart Storage Systems. My name is Lukas Weber and I will be giving this presentation, but the research paper itself was a co-joint work between our group, the Embedded Systems and Applications Group at TU Darmstadt, and the Database Lab at Reutlingen University. To start out this presentation, I want to first give you an overview over the regular database stack, what we call a data-to-code stack. In that case, data is stored on the flash chips of an SSD or potentially also an HDD, and within the same device, you typically also have a compatibility layer, which ensures that you can use that SSD with whatever system you choose to. On top of the SSD within the operating system, you then have a block device driver and a file system, which allow you the management of the data on the SSD. And you might also run a database manager like RocksDB on top, which then allows you to actually do like typical database operations on your data. Now, if you want to use your RocksDB database to actually compute a workload, the CPU will have to request the data from the SSD, and the data will be propagated through all of these intermediate layers to the main memory, where it is then processed by the CPU before the result is further transferred to another system or back to the SSD. While this is an acceptable approach in most cases, it's not necessarily the best way. And a different approach is the code-to-data approach. This is also the approach that we are using in this paper. And the main difference is that we replace the SSD with the Cosmos Plus Open SSD. In difference to a regular SSD, the Cosmos Plus Open SSD has a SYNC 7000 SoC by the manufacturer Xilinx as its main chip, and also flash memory attached to it. And instead of a regular RocksDB, we are also running a different database system, specifically the NKV system, which was also co-jointly developed by us and the DB Lab at University Reutlingen. And in that case, instead of just retrieving the data from the SSD, you are also able to basically invoke certain computations on the SSD itself. And these computations can then be performed either by the CPU or by the FPGA portion on device, and only the results have to be transported back to the CPU. This in turn frees up compute resources on the host CPU, which can be used for other tasks, and it also decreases, or typically decreases, the amount of bandwidth that is necessary to transfer the data between the SSD and the host CPU. After this short comparison of a regular stack and an NDP stack, I also want to highlight the three main points that are important about near data processing. The first one is that computation can happen close to the data. And as you can see, I've highlighted the can part here, because it is not necessarily always the best option to do your computations close to the data. In some cases, it makes sense, especially when bandwidth is a limiting factor, because typically you will have operations that filter or select data from a bigger data set. And due to this selection, you will then only need to transfer a smaller result set to the host, which frees up bandwidth and also frees up computational resources on the host CPU. In addition, you can also remove all of these intermediate compatibility layers if you allow your database manager to actually directly interact with the physical flash pages. These both combined already allow you to increase the performance of your overall database systems. And in addition, using NDP, you also gain fine granular control over the available storage and compute resources. In addition to these three main points, I also want to go into the three main types of near data processing that you can do using a device like the Cosmos OpenSSD. First, we have the software-based near data processing. And in that case, due to the removal of the compatibility layers in the SSD, you free up compute resources on the ARM cores of the Cosmos Plus, which you can then use to actually perform, for example, selections or projections of the data without having to do them on the host CPU. While this is already a good approach, it is not necessarily the best approach. A second approach, for example, is the hardware-based NDP. And in that case, instead of using the ARM cores, you could also move your computational load into the FPGA portion. Well, this would require you to supply corresponding hardware accelerators, which are generally relatively hard to build. It would also give you the opportunity to have less software interaction, and it would also allow you to potentially go even faster. But as I've said, this comes at the price of hardware development and the necessity to build very custom and highly specific accelerators for your current database problem. Last but not least, we have a hybrid approach where you basically identify recurring problems in your database operations, and instead of building very custom, very complex hardware accelerators for the overall problems, you build smaller ones which are specifically suited for recurring tasks that you can then control using a software, so that the complex part of the computation, which is hard to do in hardware, happens in the on-device CPU, so in the ARM cores of the Cosmos Plus OpenSSD, and the well-acceleratable sub-problems are then processed within the hardware accelerators, which are much more simple in that case. And this allows you to exploit the on-device compute resources as well as the on-device logic resources. And this in turn allows you to go even faster with your overall database system. Now, I've given you a lot of reasons for doing near data processing, especially using hardware acceleration, so that the question comes up that why isn't everyone doing this? And the reason for that, at least in my opinion, is that the hybrid and hardware NDP approach also has certain downsides. First of all, if you want to do a hybrid or hardware-based NDP, you require device-specific knowledge because you have to program for the FPGA portion of the Cosmos Plus OpenSSD or for the ARM core portion of the chip, and that requires you to have corresponding knowledge about FPGA development or embedded system development. And that is not generally available for a typical database engineer. Then second, and that is also included in the first point, is the background in hardware design. Specifically, database engineers typically are not very fluent in hardware description languages, so it is very hard for them to start out in that field. So they have to acquire the corresponding skills, and that takes time. Last but not least, the overall hardware design process, at least in comparison to database engineering or software design, is typically more tedious and more time-consuming due to the long development and debug cycles, and that makes it very hard to get into hardware-accelerated or hybrid NDP problems, especially if you're coming from the database side of things where you typically don't have the required background. Next, I want to go into the application that we actually took a look at in our research paper. And the application that we considered is a general purpose key value store and the two most common operations within such a key value store. Specifically, we took a look at the get operation and the scan operation, where the get operation retrieves the value of a single key from a set of key value pairs, whereas the scan operation will retrieve all key value pairs that match a predefined predicate. The overall application is then set up in a way that has an application running on top of NKV, and NKV then issues requests from the host CPU to the Cosmos Plus OpenSSD, and the Cosmos Plus OpenSSD acts as a smart storage device and executes these computational workload requests on device without interacting with the host. Only the result sets are then transferred back to the host CPU. If you typically target an application like this, you will go through the following development flow. You will start out with your NKV or RocksDB based database application, and you will identify the problem that you want to accelerate using hardware accelerators. As soon as you have that identified, you can start your hardware development, and soon after you will typically have an interface definition that you can use to also start development on the software interface, which directly interacts with your hardware accelerator, as well as the overall firmware for the Cosmos Plus OpenSSD. And as soon as the hardware development, the software development, and the overall firmware are finished, you can then integrate them together into the resulting firmware that you can deploy onto your Cosmos Plus OpenSSD and then use the overall system. And while this actually looks relatively simple, you have to realize that the hardware development is typically relatively tedious, and also the software development and the hardware development are very much codependent on each other, because you have to fine-tune your software to the hardware accelerator and the other way around so that they can actually work together without any problems. In our case, we tried to actually solve this problem of the codependency between the hardware development and the software development, and we introduce a framework which actually generates an accelerator for the get and the scan operation, using a generative approach. And using this generative approach, you basically just have to use a database application, identify the parts that you want to accelerate in hardware, so the filtering and the data transformations that you want to perform in hardware. Then you can use annotated C code to specify the problems that you want to solve using hardware acceleration. You will put that through the hardware generation, and you can immediately move to the integration and the testing and the deployment without having that problem with the codependent hardware and software development. The accelerators that we actually generate are also relatively simple in their structure. In the overall system, we assume that the data is already retrieved from the flash memory using the flash controller on the Cosmos Plus OpenSSD, and the data is then stored in the DRAM on device. And then our generated accelerator will typically be configured using an XI4 Lite control interface and a control register file, for which you basically just determine the corresponding addresses of the data block that you want to process and where you want to store the result for the load and the store unit. And then you can also set up the predicate for the filtering unit, as well as like different performance metrics which are measured in the data transform unit. Now, if you start the execution of this accelerator, the data block will be loaded by the load unit, and the data that is loaded will be forwarded into the input tuple buffer, where it is ensured that the filtering unit always receives complete key value pairs. So independent of the sizes of the different buses here, the filtering unit will always consider a single key value pair at a time and apply a predicate to a single key value pair at a time. If the predicate matches for this single key value pair, the data is then forwarded into the data transform unit. If it doesn't match, it is just discarded. In the data transform unit, we then apply a predefined projection to the data that, for example, can be used to remove unnecessary metadata or to perform projections from one data type to another data type, before the data is then put into the output tuple buffer, which ensures that the write back of the files can happen in the corresponding sizes that are required, and the data is then forwarded into the store unit, which actually does that. The advantages of our approach are very simple. You do not require any hardware design background. You can just use C code, annotated C code. You put the annotated C code into our generator, and the generator will automatically give you back processing elements and interfaces, which you can then use to solve get and scan problems in your database system. In addition, the integration also becomes a relatively easy task due to the fact that the interfaces of the generated processing elements are typically very similar to each other. So if you have integrated one of these accelerators, you should be able to integrate all of them. Overall, the resulting design flow is much easier and a lot faster than what we did before. And since we have experience with this from prior work, we actually know that the design flow is speed up very much. In addition to these obvious advantages, there are also some further additions that we have made over the prior work which used custom-built accelerators for the same problem type. First of all, using the generative approach, it is very easy to introduce multi-stage filtering, which allows you to filter for more complex predicates. And this is achieved by simply chaining multiple filtering units after each other. In addition, we introduce a feature which allows you to disregard unimportant data. This is especially interesting if you have some data fields that are very big in their size, but you don't actually want to filter for them because they are just unnecessary string data or something like that. In that case, you can just annotate the corresponding parts of your data, and this will not be used for the filtering predicates, but this will also save logic resources. Last but not least, the main addition of this framework is the generation from annotated C code. And to give you a view on that, we have an example here. This annotation here basically defines a parser, which parses the 0.3D data type into the 0.2D data type by applying a certain mapping, which says that the output.x is equal to the input.y. So in the resulting data type, this input value will be moved to x, which basically transforms your data. This can also be used in more complex ways. In addition, we define the chunk size, which says that we always process blocks of 32 kilobytes. And we define the incoming and the outgoing data by using these type defs. Now we want to take a look at the disadvantages of our approach. Whenever you're using a generative approach in comparison to very highly specialized and customized hardware, you will typically have slightly less performance and you will have slightly increased hardware utilization. And exactly that is the case in our work. So in comparison to the prior work where we custom built these accelerators and optimized them for the specific use case we were looking at, the generated accelerators will typically require a bit more hardware resources and they will also have slightly decreased performance. To give you a more detailed look on this, we will now go into the evaluation. First, we want to look at performance, specifically of the get operation. Here on the left side, you see the hardware execution times, so the execution times of a get operation using the hardware acceleration. In our current work using the generated approach in blue, as well as the prior work which used the custom built accelerators. And you can see that the performance of the custom built accelerators is slightly better than with the generated ones. While this difference looks relatively big, it actually is not. And we prove this by also running the software execution where the accelerators are not even used. And we can see that in that case, the execution using the new approach is also less performant than the previous designed version. And the reason for that lies in changes that we have made to the firmware that increase the robustness, but also decrease the overall performance. And that is the case independent of whether or not you're using the generated or the designed approach. Overall, we can say the get operation is not super parallelizable, and therefore the execution times using accelerators is typically not better than using just software. This is different in the case of the scan operation, which is very parallelizable. And here we can see that independent of the hardware and the software execution, the execution times of the generated versus the designed accelerators are more or less identical. And using the hardware acceleration will typically improve your performance by quite a big margin. Next, we want to take a look at the hardware utilization. In this case, we consider two different types of accelerators. For the full accelerators in orange, the complete data structure is parsable and you can execute your predicates on all of the fields within the struct. Whereas for the half type, about half of the, not about half, but half of the data is basically disregarded using the disregard feature. And we can see that the slice utilization basically increases with the struct size that you want to process. And while this does not look very linear, it more or less is due to the fact that we double the amount of bits from each data point to the next. In addition, we only show you the slice utilization due to the fact that no DSPs or BRAM are actually used in these designs. So the utilization of DSPs and BRAMs is zero in both cases. Next, and also last, we want to take a look at the multi-stage filtering feature. Again, we look at half and full accelerators using different numbers of filtering stages. And you can see relatively easily that the amount of overhead for adding an additional filtering stage is actually more or less constant. And this means that adding additional filtering stages is roughly requires a linear increase in hardware. But the overall hardware required is not that big. So if we consider the overall architecture here, we see that the amount of hardware that is used for the filtering stage is actually only a very small portion of the overall used hardware. What that means is you can easily increase the amount of filtering stages without increasing the hardware utilization by a huge margin, which allows you to have a much more flexible and much more functional overall acceleration unit. So to come to a conclusion, what we have shown in this work is that our generated accelerators are able to achieve almost similar performance and utilization than the custom-built ones in prior work. We have significantly decreased the development overhead for database engineers and lowered the barrier of entry for database engineers. And we also offer more functionality and more flexibility with these generated accelerators, at least in comparison to the custom-built ones that we used beforehand. Thank you very much for your attention. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me. And thanks again for your attention.